Hey, my Google ITers, I'm so glad that you are taking the CMP 155 course and the CMP 156. You actually need to be in both of them because we'll do the first part of the Google IT course and then we'll do the second part of the Google IT course. Together, those two courses will get you certified in Google IT support. So a little bit about me. Let's start there. I'm going to do a bunch of these little videos and I'll keep them 10 minutes so they're not too long, but you'll need to watch them because I've got a little test that you'll have to take in order to open up the information and get started. Now, the reason I do this is because the honest truth is it saves you a lot of time. I'll have people that'll just jump in and they'll start going. And then a week later, they're like, hey, what about this? What about that? And it's like, it's in the videos that you should have watched. So I have you watch the videos, then I ask you a few questions so that you can show me you know what's going on in the course, and then you move forward. It really will not take you long. So with that, a little bit about myself. I started a long time ago. You know, I was a teenager in the 80s, so I got to see all this tech stuff grow and become what it is, which has been fantastic. I actually started as a customer service representative, which is what this prepares you for. It's where a lot of IT people start. And there's some logic to that. I'm not going to discuss that here, but there's some logic to why that happens that way. In any case, I really love my job doing that. I actually got a bachelor's in education. And I know you'd think, well, you're a teacher, so that was good. And it definitely has helped me. That's true. But it didn't actually prepare me to get this job. In other words, I could not teach technology with that certification. As a matter of fact, the reason I got into technology was just because I had taken a ton of computer courses and I had this bachelor's degree. And so a company took a chance on me and hired me to you know, see what I could do. And it worked out really well. I worked for them about 3 years, but I just wasn't making enough money. So then I went after some industry certifications, which I have a video on later about, you know, the importance of industry certifications. And I got those and immediately got a job doing networking. I became a systems administrator. I became a network administrator, a security admin. I did a ton of different stuff during the 15 years that I worked in technology. And it was great. And I loved it very much, but I loved teaching more. And so after getting a master's degree and some hours in actual tech classes that you have to take, those upper level classes, I started working at EAC full time. So I try to bring a lot of really practical information to my courses because I feel that you need to be prepared as you go out there. And so you're going to have a bunch of information I've thrown in there to help you through this certification. It's not anything that you have to do to get this certification, but it's there to just kind of help you. And I want to say I've helped a lot of people through this certification process. And you really, honestly, when you get into something in this course and you're just like, I don't understand what they're telling me, reach out to me. I'll get back to you as quickly as possible. I'll create a video like this, or I'll just type it out to you and give you a different take on what they're saying or more background on what they're saying to help you through. And so I'm glad you're here. The next video, we'll talk about what is this Google IT certification. So glad you're in class again, and make sure that you let me know what's going on if you're having trouble with things.